between 93 and about 2004, 2005, there was a real proliferation, a real big growth in the sport of women's rowing in terms of the number of schools that were sponsoring it at the varsity level and obviously the number of women that are competing now. We've had a lot of recent success. Last year, we were Big Ten champions and then NCAA champions. So really right now, we're at the pinnacle of our success. Ultimately, the crew that's going to be crowned the champion is going to be the boat that gets from point A to point B the fastest. A boat race is going to be, well, for a gold medal standard at the NCAA championship in the top event, you're going to be 6 minutes and 20 seconds. And that's a 6 minute and 20 second all out effort.
So the rowing stroke begins with the catch. Your seat is up as far on the slide as it can go, and your arms are fully extended, and the oar is in the water. Your torso is pivoted at the hips. Your blade first goes in the water there, and then the drive is where you press down with your legs. You open up your back and then draw in with the arms. That is where you're at the finish and your blade is out of the water there. And then you slowly recover, let the seat come up to the catch again. And as you're going up to the catch, you let your hands lift up and drop the blade into the water again.
The interesting part from my perspective is where the blade meets the water, and that's where you start to get the fluid mechanics.
Yeah. It's interesting because you can feel the science when you're rowing. Where the blade meets the water has probably been the biggest change in rowing in my 30 plus years in the sport. The only moment that I can recall in my rowing career where somebody came up with something and everybody went, uh-oh, was going from the Macon oar to the hatchet blade.
So you're moving the water one way and your boat is moving corresponding the other way. So more specifically, what you're looking at is you're imparting a certain amount of momentum, mass times velocity, to the water, and in response, you're moving with that equal momentum. As soon as you get moving then, an object in motion will stay in motion, and an object will stay at rest, tends to stay at rest, unless you have some external force acting on it. And of course, the external force acting on it in this case is that resistive force from the water.
So when they're designing these things, right, you're considering power versus the resistance. So you can only get so much power with the crew you have. However, if you minimize that resistance, then ultimately you get more speed out of it.
There's a lot of engineering involved in rowing. You can have mechanical engineering, biomechanical engineering, civil engineering, structural engineering, materials science and engineering, even everything to like biomedical with the movement of the body. So it spans quite a few engineering disciplines. I'm a Buckeye engineer and I'm a Buckeye rower, so I guess you could say I'm engineered for speed.